To him whose elastic and vigorous thoughts keep pace with the sun, the day is perpetual morning. It matters not what the clocks say or attitudes of men and labors of men. Morning is when I am awake, and there is a dawn in me.
Food is all gone. You ate it too quick. There's nothing left. Now what are we gonna do? This is our pet sheep. This is the sheep that Lester and the family raised from a little one in their barn. And he is so friendly, he can't keep away from them.
Isn't that right, huh?
Get on too. Stand here in front of ours. Mm-hmm. Sure.
Don't knock that thing off.
Would you see yourself with the seven?
Oh,
That's about all that's left of the pigs. Just a big pile. And you see what happened? They didn't eat all of their corn. Let's see how it's doing. Doesn't look too hot. I guess that it's a product of what it's growing in. Wonder who that could be. Ed speaking.
What are you doing?
What am I doing? Oh, I'm just standing here in the barnyard thinking about the pigs and standing right in the middle of it all.
Right in the middle of what?
You know.
You mean?
Right in the barnyard.
Shoveling stuff?
Yeah. Looking at the corn, it's amazing how well the corn has grown in it.
I remember seeing that. You gonna get the ears off of that?
There's quite a good ear. It's not doing too badly. I think the sheep are going to like it.
Yeah, what else going on?
That's about it. It's a beautiful day.
No rain?
No, really gorgeous.
Find any other unusual goodies laying around anywhere?
No, nothing unusual.
Well, go back and get the shoveling.
Okay, we'll see you.
So long.
Bye.
How can a man's life keep its course if he will not let it flow? Those who flow as life knows how, they need no other force. They feel no wear, they feel no tear, they need no mending, no repair.
Today. Oh, we got one in the nest.
Come on, up she goes. Come on, I need your eggs.
A whole basket of eggs. Three. You did very well today. Very well. Can I get you something to eat?
My good friends, the Robinsons, who live just down the road a piece, dug ponds and stocked them with trout this spring. Tony gets to feed them. Now I see the secret of making the best persons. It is to grow in the open air and to eat and sleep with the earth.
Oh, this is cold water. Look at that little puppy. It's been over time.
One of the best paying professions is getting a hold of pieces of country in our mind. Learning their smell and their moods, sorting out the pieces of a view, deciding what grows there and why, how many steps that hill will take, where this creek winds and where it meets the other one below. This is the best kind of ownership and the most permanent. Is it not by his high superfluousness we know our God? For to equal a need is natural, animal, mineral. But to fling rainbows over the rain, and beauty above the moon, and secret rainbows on dunes of deep seashells. Not even the weeds to multiply without blossom, nor the birds without music. Look how beautiful are all the things that he does. His signature is the beauty of things.
Most of this great collection of pots came from Grandma up north at the cottage. One can never really have enough pots with as many houseplants as I seem to accumulate. Grandma was always fond of plants and violets, and I sure seem to have inherited a lot of pots.
The universe is deathless. Is deathless because, having no finite self, it stays infinite. A sound man, by not advancing himself, stays the further ahead of himself. By not confining himself to himself, sustains himself outside himself. By never being an end in himself, he endlessly becomes himself.